SpaceX team slowly prepare the first orbital-class Starship and Super Heavy booster. For now, it's almost impossible to say when Starship S-20 and Super Heavy B-4 will be ready for their orbital launch debut, as that now lies almost solely in the hands of the FAA. A NASA document discussing a group's plans to document SpaceX's first orbital velocity, Starship reentry appears to suggest that the next generation rocket's orbital launch debut has slipped several months into 2022. In March 2021, CEO Elon Musk confirmed a report that SpaceX was working towards a target of July 2021 for Starship's first orbital launch attempt. At the time, it seemed undeniably ambitious but far from impossible. Less than half a year prior, SpaceX had kicked off a series of suborbital Starship test flights to altitudes of 10 to 12.5 kilometers. Beginning in December 2020, SN8, effectively the first structurally complete Starship prototype, nearly stuck a landing on its first try, only narrowly falling short due to an engine and pressurization issue. However, further stoking the fires of optimism, Starship SN15 debuted a number of upgrades and became the first prototype to successfully launch, land, and survive a approximately 10 kilometers test flight in early May. Put simply, SpaceX built five Starship prototypes practically from scratch in roughly 8 months and then completed five test flights in less than 5 months, all of which were largely successful. However, for reasons that are less than clear, that August 6th full-stack milestone is about where SpaceX's H1 2021 momentum appeared to run into a brick wall. Perhaps due to a desire to focus on orbital launch site construction, even at the cost of avoiding road closures or testing that would require a clear pad. Starship S-20 sat on a stand for the better part of 2 months before completing even a minor test, by far the longest any Starship prototype has waited. Seemingly in the midst of its third round of Raptor engine removal, Super Heavy B-4 has yet to attempt a single test, and it's unclear how close to ready the orbital pad is to support booster proof and static fire tests. Neither ship nor booster has attempted to static fire its Raptor engines, though S-20 complete its first preburner engine test on Monday, October 18. Combined with recent developments in the FAA's Boca Chica environmental review process, the odds of SpaceX attempting the first orbital Starship launch by the end of 2021 have rapidly dropped from decent to near zero. From a technical perspective, it seems likely that SpaceX could still be ready for an orbital launch attempt just a few months from now. From a regulatory perspective, though, it would be practically unprecedented for the FAA to complete a favorable environmental review and approve even a one-off orbital Starship launch license in approximately 10 weeks. Ultimately, after 2 months with next to no prototype testing, it's beginning to look like SpaceX has decided to focus on finishing Starbase's first orbital launch site. Refining vehicle designs, and building new prototypes B-5, S-21, S-22, rather than pushing hard for rapid B-4, S-20 testing, and an imminent launch attempt. As a result, it's becoming increasingly unlikely that Booster 4 and Ship 20 will fly as new and improved prototypes like Super Heavy B-5 and Starship S-21 prepare to overtake them. This week saw some important ground support work take place. The booster catching arms, nicknamed MECHAZILLA by SpaceX, are undergoing final work before their installation on the orbital launch tower. These two arms will be used to catch returning Super Heavy boosters, eliminating the need for heavy landing legs on the booster itself. This is important because extra mass on the rocket means reduced payload capacity. The two arms themselves, nicknamed chopsticks, were installed onto the carriage, which will support them and move them up and down the tower. This complete assembly is currently residing on a temporary structure on the ground. As crews perform the final work, the assembly will then be installed onto the launch tower. In the near future, MECHAZILLA will also be used to stack Starships and boosters onto the orbital launch mount. Since they can move up and down the tower, the arms will be used as a lifting device, eliminating the need to keep a separate crane on site. In the last 2 days, SpaceX has transported a giant mystery tank, and the second-to-last, cryoshell, to Starbase's orbital tank farm, pushing Starship's first orbital-class launch site a step closer to completion. Built in the same Starbase facilities, with the same techniques and out of the same parts as Starship tanks, SpaceX's custom storage tanks are likely cheaper than alternatives. Just next door, the orbital tank farm is undergoing proof tests before its activation. On September 28, venting was observed from one of the new tanks. These large tanks are essentially made of Starship segments, allowing SpaceX to build their own tanks to their own specifications. In order to ensure that there are no leaks, and that the new tanks can withstand holding cryogenic propellants, they were filled with liquid nitrogen. Not all of the tanks are complete, so proof testing has been going one tank at a time. The completion and activation of the orbital tank farm will be one of the largest milestones in the construction of the orbital launch site. Once its completed testing of Super Heavy boosters can begin, on the launch mount, Booster 4 is still awaiting completion of the launch site to begin its own test campaign. This booster will loft ship 20 part way to orbit, on the orbital flight test likely scheduled for early next year. Over the past few weeks, several Raptor engines were removed from Booster 4. These engines were likely shipped back to SpaceX's test site in McGregor, Texas, where some other exciting activities are taking place. But more on that later. Speaking of Ship 20, it's currently stationed on suborbital Pad B, deep into its own test campaign. The vehicle completed its preburner engine test, and is nearing a static fire of its Raptor engines. A Raptor vacuum engine was installed onto Ship 20. On October 12, Raptor vacuums are optimized for use in the vacuum of space, and are much more efficient than normal Raptor engines. Outside of the atmosphere, Ship 20 is the first Starship to feature these new engines. It's currently unknown whether Ship 20 static fire campaign will include just the sea-level Raptors, or firing the Raptor vacuums, as well. The static fire test of Ship 20 may take place as soon as this week. At the production site, work on Ship 21 and Booster 5 is picking up speed. Ship 21's nose cone resides inside tent number 3, with a sizable number of heat shield tiles. Attached, a tank section of the future ship was spotted inside the mid-bay, indicating that stacking should begin soon. Also, the common domed section for Ship 22 was seen outside. With tile attachment points already installed inside the high bay, the stacking of Booster 5 is well underway. Recently, the grid fins were installed onto the top half of the vehicle. Booster 5 is currently in two sections inside the high bay. Booster 5 and Ship 21 are currently expected to take flight for the second orbital flight test. Foundation work is progressing for the new wider high bay. This building will be similar to the existing high bay, but a little taller and much wider. This extra space will be used to process multiple Starships and Super Heavy boosters simultaneously. Finally, some major Starship-related work is taking place outside of Boca Chica, at SpaceX's test site in McGregor, Texas. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.